This is a demonstration of how to use the Mishnah Maitreya Rosary. First, we will quickly explain each part of the rosary and then have the demonstration. Start at the end with the three B's. The first large B, the beginning, symbolizes the Father. The middle B symbolizes the Son. And the third large B symbolizes the Holy Ghost, Mother Grace. So you can start your rosary meditation in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Then we go to the side with the seven beads. These seven beads symbolize the seven seals. While touching each of the beads in this portion, remember all the things related to the corresponding seal. After finishing with the first portion of the seven beads, there is a large bead, the Hash bead. This bead will be repeated after any section is reached. When we reach this bead, we remember or recite Hari Om Shri Hum Om Nam Kevalam. Then we also remember what it means. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything. After this first Hash mantra bead, there are four small beads. They are to remind us of what the essence of God is. Tama, Raja, Sattva, the creative force's mother, and the consciousness, Father. After the second Hash mantra bead, there are seven beads for the seven verses of the reminder. Then there are 15 beads for the 15 commandments. With touching each bead, remember that commandment, then remember what that commandment stands for, its meaning, how it is related to the Ten Commandments, etc. Then there are reminder beads again. This will be the second time you recite the reminder with touching each bead and reciting the related verses or verse. Then there is the Divine Path section. With touching each of these seven beads, remember the related sections from the Divine Path Sutra, which we recite after collective meditation. There is another section for the reminder. This will be the third time you recite the reminder with touching each bead and reciting the related verse or verses. Then there is the 33 Virtues section. There are 33 beads in this section. With touching each one, remember the 33 virtues. End with the four small beads. They represent the four parts of the holy word you receive in your initiation. The first initiation is related to the bead closest to the rosary, the second is the next, and so on. The fourth initiation is the furthest from the rosary. These do not include the introductory initiation. So, the rosary is finished by remembering the parts of the word you have been initiated with.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, Mother.
Seven seals in the greatest sign. First seal, mystical path. Second seal, communities of life.
Third seal, sacrifice.
Fourth seal, surrendering and submission.
Fifth seal, universalism.
Sixth seal, paravipra.
Seventh seal, pure consciousness.
Hari Om Shri Ram Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
Tamaguna,
Rajaguna,
Sattvaguna,
consciousness.
Hari Om Shri Ram Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
The reminder.
We pay our salutations to the Divine Father, who has helped all come from ignorance to the path of enlightenment. Ignorance is the state of unawareness of the reality behind this universe, and enlightenment is the state of pure consciousness. We open our hearts to your grace and pray for your guidance in overcoming the power of the tamaguna over our souls and detaching ourselves from Maya. We adore and promise to endeavor to help the whole universe to reach higher consciousness and eventually pure consciousness. In reverence, we bow our heads in front of all those great souls in the past and those to come who have helped and will help all to understand your compassion and mercy in your actions and creation. We surrender ourselves to you, the words revealed to us through your prophets and your greatest sign, which clarifies the confusion between all. We submit only to you, which is formless, nameless, and invisible. You in this state unify. In any other state, humanity will be divided. Also, this will prevent us from surrendering to false prophets and teachers. However, in reverence we bow our heads in front of all those great souls who will teach us how to know you and show us the way to become pure consciousness, as is the goal. Hari Om Shri Ham Om Nam Kevala. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
15 Commandments. Submission. The Divine Father in Heaven is one, invisible, nameless, and the greatest.
Surrendering. Do not go to complete prostration. Submit to anyone or thing except Him, the words revealed through His prophets, and the greatest sign, which clarifies the confusion between all.
Goal of the life. Remember the goal of the life, which is to reach pure consciousness and help others to reach the same.
Messenger. Consider the prophets, sadgurus, avatars, or likewise as God's messengers to bring His messages and laws to humanity.
Elect. Accept Paraviras as the chosen ones to establish and enforce the laws, to spread the messages of God, and to establish the kingdom of heaven.
Nonviolence, not violating the Dharma.
Truthfulness, with discriminating minds, to guide all thought, speech, and action with the spirit of welfare.
Not to feel, non-feeling, physically, mentally, or spiritually. Do not take things which belong to others by thought, by taking action, or by preventing them from doing their duty or possessing things which belong to them.
Non-indulgence. Not to indulge in the enjoyment of such amenities and comforts as are superficial to the preservation of life.
Attachment to God. To keep the mind immersed in the ideation of God. To remain attached to God and to accept Him as the only refuge, the only King, and His laws as the only law.
Internal and external cleanliness. To maintain purity and cleanliness of mind, body, and environment.
Contented and mental ease. To remain in a state of mental equanimity and contentment.
Satsang, service, and meditation. To attain true satsang when people talk only about God, the universe, and His will. To practice penance in the service of others as being done for the Lord in creating communities of love. And to sincerely meditate and or do the reminder at least twice a day.
Understanding God and His laws through the scriptures, to clearly understand the underlying meaning of the scriptures and discourses of spirituality.
To become divine, to strive to become perfect in our actions as God is, to ideate that He does the divine actions through us, and to become a perfect instrument for His will to be done, until able to radiate His divine universal truth through ourselves.
Hariyom Sherikam, Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
The reminder.
We pay our salutation to the Divine Father, who has helped all come from ignorance to the path of enlightenment. Ignorance is the state of unawareness of the reality behind this universe, and enlightenment is the state of pure consciousness. We open our hearts to your grace and pray for your guidance in overcoming the power of the Tamaguna over our souls and detaching ourselves from Maya. We adore and promise to endeavor to help the whole universe to reach higher consciousness and eventually pure consciousness. In reverence, we bow our heads in front of all those great souls in the past and those to come who have helped and will help all to understand your compassion and mercy in your actions and creation. We surrender ourselves to you, the words revealed to us through your prophets, and your greatest sign, which clarifies the confusion between all. We submit only to you, which is formless, nameless, and invisible. You in this state unify. In any other state, humanity will be divided. Also, this will prevent us from surrendering to false prophets and teachers. However, in reverence we bow our heads in front of all those great souls who will teach us how to know you and show us the way to become pure consciousness, as is the goal. Hari Om Shri Ham Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
Divine Path. The thought, love, and peace of God will arise in those who perform meditation and or the reminder twice a day or more regularly.
They will become an instrument for His will.
Sacrifice all for this idea.
Surrender and submit unto Him.
And become a universalist at last.
Also, they follow the 15 commandments. With these, they will become the elect.
Win His grace and reach their goal. Maitreya.
Hari Om Shri Ham Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
The reminder.
We pay our salutations to the Divine Father, who has helped all come from ignorance to the path of enlightenment. Ignorance is the state of unawareness of the reality behind this universe, and enlightenment is the state of pure consciousness. We open our hearts to your grace and pray for your guidance in overcoming the power of the Tamaguna over our souls and detaching ourselves from Maya. We adore and promise to endeavor to help the whole universe to reach higher consciousness and eventually pure consciousness. In reverence, we bow our heads in front of all those great souls in the past and those to come who have helped and will help all to understand your compassion and mercy in your actions and creation. We surrender ourselves to you, the words revealed to us through your prophets, and your greatest sign, which clarifies the confusion between all. We submit only to you, which is formless, nameless, and invisible. You in this state unify. In any other state, humanity will be divided. Also, this will prevent us from surrendering to false prophets and teachers. However, in reverence we bow our heads in front of all those great souls who will teach us how to know you and show us the way to become pure consciousness, as is the goal. Hari Om Shri Ham Om Nam Kevalam. The goal of the life is to become divine. That divinity, God, is everything.
33 virtues. Fearlessness.
Purification of one's existence. Cultivation of spiritual and intellectual knowledge.
Charity.
Self-control, perpetual restraint of behavior and temper.
Performance of sacrifice, selfless service, not being self-centered, to become humble.
Study of spiritual scriptures.
Austerity and simplicity.
Non-violence, not violating the Dharma of things.
Truthfulness, freedom from anger,
renunciation, to offer the result of your actions to the Lord and ideate that your body is a tool for Him to perform divine actions.
Tranquility, magnanimity of mind,
aversion to fault finding.
Compassion and freedom from covetousness.
Gentleness.
Modesty and steady determination.
Vigor.
Forgiveness.
Fortitude.
Cleanliness.
Freedom from envy.
Patience for honor.
Readiness to sacrifice everything of individual life for the ideology.
Sweet and smiling behavior.
Moral courage.
Setting an example by individual conduct before asking anyone to do the same.
Strict adherence to the 15 commandments.
Constant contemplation of the greatest sign.
Even while dealing with a person of inimical nature, one must keep oneself free from hatred, anger, and vanity.
Keep aloof from talkativeness, idle talk.
Obedience to the structural code of discipline.
Sense of responsibility.
Then the rosary is finished by silently remembering the parts of the word you have been initiated with the four beads. Hello.